Hey Collective, we're going to do a quick energy check, see what your spirit guides want you to know, what's going on behind the scenes. I've already meditated, called in the appropriate protection. This is a timeless reading, so it's whenever it finds you. We're going to jump right into this. I tried to do a recording just a little couple of minutes ago, and it just stopped. The first card that came out is look for the positive in every situation. You could be a Taurus. You can have Taurus anywhere in your chart. Completion. You are divinely protected. I was just going to say Taurus also represents your work, your home, material, money, your stability. And what went flying on the car, the floor, is somebody was worshiping money, false gods, and celebrities. You can't be stopped. Get ready. There's been a completion here. Somebody wasn't living life right. Some of you guys are clairsentient. You get chills, gut instincts, your emotions. Okay. Worships money, false gods, and celebrities. Some of you guys release that old belief system. Hi, Maya. There's been a completion for somebody here. They released it. They released the worshiping the money, the false gods, the celebrities. They're looking at the positive in every situation. There's been a completion. Show us the cards we need to see. Yeah, they got in their confidence. They started working on their creative projects. Yeah, they released that old traditional belief system. They wasn't living right. Yeah, whatever they were working on, worshiping money, false gods, celebrities, it didn't get them nowhere. It kept them in hangman. Got them a broken heart. You can't be stopped. A lot of, yeah, look it. Released it. They released it. They released it. Manifestations. Magician. There's a reason to celebrate here. Somebody released those burdens. They healed. From believing the old traditional ways. They've completed a cycle. They've completed. They thought that that was going to help them get the desired outcome. They thought that that was going to help. They had to release that. They release the codependency of that belief. Whatever this belief, worshiping money, false gods, celebrities, they released it. Yeah, they freed themselves. They freed themselves. They released, they freed themselves from that codependency, old tradition, old belief system. This person was in hangman because whatever they were working on, it wasn't getting them anything. It wasn't getting them anywhere. It just got them burdened, heartache, stuck, investing in things that were not flourishing. Yeah, they're listening to their intuition now. Clairsentience, feelings, gut instincts, emotions. What else did it? Somebody's released that belief. They're looking at the positive in every situation. Yeah, they released it. Healing, transformation. They were stuck in their head. They were confused. They were confused. They thought that it was going to get them the Ten of Pentacles, but it got them nothing. They possibly walked away from their Empress, who's a high priestess. They probably walked away from their Empress, chose money, false gods, celebrities over their Empress. Yeah, look, they released it. The old tradition, the Hierophant. They released it. They cut the air supply from that old belief system. It could have been outdated belief systems from old programming, from seeing their mothers doing it, their fathers doing it, their uncles doing it, their grandfathers doing it. This is the way my grandfather did it. This is the way my father did it. This is the way my mother did it. This is how the community does it. This is what I see in the community. This is what I see in the social media, in the news outlets. This is what I see. So they thought that was the way. It was an internal conflict. They stood in Hangman. They released it. And now they're listening to their intuition. Yeah, they released it. They possibly had a decision. They walked away from their divine counterpart. They released their divine counterpart. Yeah. Yeah. Okay, what else, Bibbit? What does the collective need to know here? Spirit is trying to show you guys what's going on. This person cut their air supply off of that old way of thinking. I seen the Hermit. This person's probably in Hermit mode. Yeah, that was the fork in the road. They had to balance. Because they were in their head going round and round and round about their yin. They were too much in their masculine, spirit showing me. This person only wants peace now in their life. Yeah, they're exchanging gifts with spirit now. They're letting their friends help them, their spirit guides. They're listening to spirit. Yeah, what they seen in their community. They were in the in-between. They were stuck from listening to their intuition, what their heart was saying, versus what they've seen their whole life. They just want to be happy. They want peace. Where did you go? They're looking for their Empress. Yep, they're looking for their Empress. They just want milk and honey. Happy, happy. Okay, Spirit, what else? Where did you go? They're being tested. They were being tested. Spirit was testing this person. They're manifesting their Empress. Expect a miracle. You're the life of this person. Romance and connection, transformation. What did I just say? This person's on their way. I've seen them in Hermit mode. There's been a transformation. This connection, you were the life for this person. It was a learning experience, Spirit said. Divine timing is at play. Where did you go? Where did you go? Possibly their family didn't approve. There's been a transformation. Free will, it's all about decision. Okay. Guys, this is what Spirit wants you guys to know. You have somebody who finally released codependencies, old beliefs, old traditions. They cut the air supply for those people, places, and things, those outdated beliefs. And they're looking at the positive in every situation now. They freed themselves. That's what I have for you guys. Love and light.